All right, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. Today is going to be a fun one. We're going to be discussing the newly added data panel that is now available in the dashboard module. This module allows you to create your ideal trading layout. Here you can see we've got two different data panels loaded, so you can see as much customizable data as you would like. We've got a chart element, the stats table to view your earnings and sales data horizontally. We've also got a watch list, a screen. So it kind of combines all the different modules and apps that we have available here in the dashboard to kind of create a really good trading dashboard that I'm sure many of you guys are familiar with. For instance, you can take a look at, you know, top stocks in the same group right here in your panel. This is clickable, so you can easily run through the different names. You can also review using any rank, whether it's a sector, industry group, or just group rank. You can click this drop down menu and see where that group kind of ranks within all the other different industries. So there's a lot of functionality here. We'll be walking through each component of it. And if you have any questions along the way, please go ahead and leave them down below in the comment section. If you're not already using Deepvue, there's a great special offer right now, 2 months for $39. The link to that is down below in the description. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. And let's say you're starting completely fresh. You don't have any dashboard set up, and we're gonna start completely new right there with you. So in order to create a new dashboard, what you wanna do is click this button right here for a new dashboard. We'll go ahead and name this tutorial two here. You can select a folder if you'd like to. You can organize a folder, create a new folder if you'd like to as well as add a description. I'll just call this data panel tutorial template. So there you go. You can go ahead and click save. You've now loaded kind of the blank slate of a dashboard. And really quick here, just before we even get started, if you want kind of a quick and easy solution, you want to use a lot of dashboards that I've personally made, or just kind of start from, you know, a good standing point, what you can do is click this drop down menu, go over to dashboard presets. And we have many different dashboard presets that you can load: bubble charts, performance charts, scatter plots, heat maps. So this is a pretty good way to get a quick jump start. But I'll be kind of, you know, walking you through everything step by step if you do want to get fully customizable and into the weeds. So let's go ahead and say you want to, you know, create your ideal trading dashboard using multiple data panels, charts, screens, watch lists. Let's go ahead and dive right in. So in order to add different apps, which are those different elements, what you wanna do is either click this button right here, or if there's already an app loaded on the dashboard, you wanna click this blue plus sign here. Either one right now loads out the different apps that you can add: chart, screener, watch list, data panel, stats table, position sizing calculator, performance chart, heat map, bubble chart. It's getting, you know, pretty awesome over here. We've got a lot of apps that we've added. And basically what you want to do is basically just click and drag to bring them onto this flexible grid over here. Now, if there are too many apps or not enough space for a new app, you may notice that some of these are grayed out, and there'll basically be an indicator that you can't drag it onto your dashboard. What you want to do in that case is just make sure that there's more room over here on the dashboard by adjusting the sizes of existing apps, and then you'll be able to drag things on and kind of readjust as you go. And we'll probably show an example of that later on, but let's go ahead and load a chart app over here. Let's go ahead and load, or here you go. You can see it right here. So right now, because of where the chart is, you're not able to load in a data panel. What you want to do is just kind of move things around and then you'll be able to. And we want two different data panels. We're going to basically recreate what I had over here. And let's go ahead and start with this. So let's go ahead and have this be kind of our top panel. So we're gonna drag that over there. This one's gonna be over to the side, so we're gonna resize it like this. And let's go ahead and drag this over here. Drag this over here. Oh, I gotta move it to the side just a little bit. So we're gonna probably be improving a little bit this drag and drop feature, maybe a little bit more intuitive, but you know, it just takes a second and you only have to set this up once really. So let's go ahead and make that. There we go. So it's already looking pretty good. We'll drag that to be the same size here, and we'll go ahead and drag that out to show that as well. So there we go. We can even increase this down to here. You can see it's revealing more of the panels that you've already got set up here, and we'll show how to edit those, add different categories, all of that in just a second. If you haven't set up a data panel just yet, we'll go ahead and show you how to do that. But let's go ahead and click the bottom arrow. That's how you resize things. You can see the arrow that shows up right here when you hover. You can drag that out. You can also do that on any of the corners. And then in the top left is how you drag and move things around. So let's go ahead and now drag in the stats table. And we'll put that down here. Drag that out. And let's go ahead and scroll a little bit. And let's go ahead and edit this. Right now it's only showing four quarters. We want to toggle on eight quarters to just see a little bit more data. And let's go ahead and make that as low as you can go. And there we go. So right now you can see, I also want to add in a watch list and a screener. Right now there's not quite enough space over here on the right hand side. So let's go ahead and move these in just a little bit. So let's go ahead and now drag in a watch list up here and a screener down here. And you can see it automatically loaded, just kind of blank ones. So let's go ahead and select a watch list preset. Let's do the mega caps. So there we go. We've got the mega caps loaded. This is now a, this is linked to the chart because they're part of the same group. That's a quick thing that I definitely want to explain. You can have different elements linked to different, other apps within here. You just want to make sure the ones you want linked are in the same number/color group. So these are all linked because they're all part of the blue or number one group, and as is this. So if you click a stock in here, this will load as well. But let's go ahead and load the Deepvue leaders. So there we go. And let's go ahead and move this down, use up all that real estate here. And we've basically got our elements ready. So let's go ahead and X this out now. You can see everything adjusts automatically. So there we go. We've got very quickly our data panels, the chart, stats table, watch lists, all that's linked to the chart. So it's very easy to navigate everything, as well as the screen if you want to take a look at these different stocks right here as you're going through your process. So this overall setup is great for analyzing both the technicals as well as fundamentals. And these data points are fully customizable. I'll show you guys how to do that in just a minute. But this is great for position traders, CANSLIM traders who want, of course, to take a look at the technicals so you can manage risk, but also want to review earnings growth, sales growth, or any other data point that you find relevant to your process. So with that said, let's go ahead and show you how to edit the different data panels if you're not familiar with that already. So that way you can tailor everything exactly to your liking. So to edit the different groups as well as the data points that show, you want to go ahead and click this gear icon. You can see that this now shows the condensed view that just shows the data points that are in the different categories within a group. You can go ahead and drag and drop to organize like that. You can also X things out if you want to delete a data point. You can also click this to rename the section, the group that you're editing, and you can also delete sections using this icon right here. To add an additional data point, you want to go ahead and either click the section you want to add that data point to, or in this drop-down menu, you want to select the different category that you want to add. So say we want to add the last price to the company info, we'd go ahead and either search last here or just kind of scroll up and down and find that, and then just go ahead and check that box. And now it's added as the last group, and we can always move it around if we'd like to reorganize things. So that's basically how you go ahead and edit the data points in here. We can, of course, delete an element, and we can also go ahead and create a new category by clicking this button. You can give it a name. I'll name this tutorial. And let's go ahead and say we want to add a volume data point here. You can see all the volume data points show up. We can add a few to this different group. You can see them appear in real time right there. And now to save it, all you have to do is X this out and it saves automatically. And now we go back and see the standard view. And to see the group we just created, you want to scroll down and see that right here. But you could, of course, move this group over here. Again, to do that, you click this gear icon. And not only are these data points drag and droppable within a group, but you can also reorganize things just like that. What makes it super easy. So that's pretty much it for that side data panel. This is already pretty much set up to my liking. You can, of course, take your time and set it up how you'd like to. You can also go ahead and check out the data panel presets. We have my own personal data panel preset in there that you can go ahead and load, or you can go ahead and check out the other ones that we've created for you. This top panel, however, I want to have a little bit of a different look. Right now, it's actually loading the same data as the side panel. So let's go ahead and change this over to the top panel that I already created. And now you can see these data points just like that. So this is pretty helpful. You can see these data points, right above the chart. They're a little bit more in the, in your line of sight. You can see ADR, price versus the 21 EMA. So as you're flipping through these different charts, these will update automatically and get a quick view of the most important information to your process. I like having the earnings data up here, the average dollar volume, shares and float, earnings growth last quarter. You can hover this to see the data point. Price versus the 21 EMA. I always like to find my entries as close to that as possible. So I like having this as a reminder. Up down volume ratio, average daily range, how volatile the stock is on average over the past 10 days, group rank 9 out of 25. And of course, you can expand this. It's easier to see it on this kind of vertical view, but you can expand it on this view as well. And we'll kind of close that as well. Price percent change today, DCR run rate. And let's go ahead and zoom out just one, and that'll make this fit a little bit nicer. So there you go. Now you can see everything is filled up nicely. So that's pretty much how to set up your data panel and your dashboard. You can get really creative with this. I'd love to see you guys, see what you guys come up with. So please tag us on Twitter if you come up with a configuration that you really like. But this is a great view, great way to show, as I mentioned, both fundamental as well as technical data all on one, screen there for you. This is great for analyzing a stock, trading a stock, executing, whatever, you want to do. You can go ahead and do this and also include the data panel now in your dashboard. So thanks so much for watching. Remember, we've got that special offer, 2 months for $39. If you're not already using Deepvue, if maybe you're on some other CANSLIM platforms, this has, so many great features. We'll be adding a lot of new data in the coming, just a few weeks now. So stay on the lookout for that. But with that said, thanks again for tuning in, and I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.